Today I shall teach the second part of the chapter, the Northern Plains, location and extent. These vast plains lie just south of the northern mountains, stretching for about 2,500 kilometers from Punjab in the west to Assam in the east. So the northern plains lies to the south of the northern mountains, and it stretches to 2,500 kilometers from Punjab in the west to Assam in the east. Origin: the plains have been formed by the deposition of sediments or silt brought down by the great rivers. So the plains are formed, these northern plains are formed by the deposition of sediments or silts brought down by the great rivers that rise from the northern mountains. Indus, Ganga and Brahmaputra and their tributaries over a millions of years. They are flat or level and very fertile. The fertile silt is known as alluvium, and so these plains are alluvial plains. So northern plain is called the alluvial plain because it is filled up with the fertile silt known as alluvium brought down by the great rivers like Indus, Ganga and Brahmaputra from the northern mountains over millions of years. So what is alluvium? Alluvium is the fertile silt brought down by the great rivers. Subdivisions: the Punjab plains, the Ganga plains, the Brahmaputra plains. Punjab plains: these plains are actually a part of the Indus plains, which lies most in Pakistan. Only the Satluj, Ravi and Bees form these plains. They lie in northwestern part of India. So the Punjab plains is mostly in Pakistan, formed by Indus, but some part is formed by Satluj, Ravi and Bees, which is in the northwestern part of India. The Ganga plains: these are formed by the Ganga and its tributaries, namely Yamuna, Gangtok, Ghagra, Gomti, Kosi and Son. These plains occupy the central part. The central India, that is just the central part of the plain, the alluvial plain, is the Ganga plains, and it is formed mostly by the Ganga and its tributaries. And these tributaries are Yamuna, Gandak, Ghagra, Gomti, Kosi and the Son. The Brahmaputra plains: these are formed by the Brahmaputra and its tributaries. These lie in the eastern part of India. So Brahmaputra plain, it is now named after the river Brahmaputra, and this plain is formed by Brahmaputra itself and its tributaries, which lies in the eastern part of India. The plains extend slightly southwards where the Ganga and the Brahmaputra meet to form the largest delta in the world. The major part of this delta lies in Bangladesh and a small portion lies in West Bengal. So the plains extend slightly southwards where Ganga and Jamuna, Brahmaputra meet to form the largest delta in the world. And this delta is divided into two parts. One part, the major part, falls in Bangladesh, and the smaller part falls in the West Bengal, in the state of West Bengal. These are covered by dense forest where the Sundari tree is very common, hence they are also known as Sundarbans. So the delta formed here is the largest in the world and it is known as Sundarbans. And it is named Sundarbans because this area is covered densely by the Sundari trees. Importance of the plains. These plains are the most densely populated regions of India. This is due to the presence of the flat, fertile plains, perennial rivers, and the favorable climate. First importance is that it is densely populated region of India because of presence of the fertile plains, the perennial rivers. Perennial river means this, the rivers which form the fertile plain, the northern plain. A perennial means the rivers which have water throughout the year, and the favorable climate. A climate favorable for the growth of the population in this part. The flat fertile plains have enabled people to grow a variety of crops of since the earliest times, and thus has earned it the name of the food bowl of India. So the importance of these plains is that it is also called the food bowl of India because variety of crops are grown here. So the farmers grow a variety of crops from the earliest times, and it is the food factory or the food bowl of India. The level plains have encouraged the building of roads and railways, helping people to move from place to place. So the level land here, the plains are the level lands, and the building of roads and railways are very easy and easier than the building of roads and railways in the mountainous regions, because mountains are somewhere steep, some are high, and so level land cannot be found. Lastly, the wide perennial rivers not only provide water for cultivation but also can be used to generate electricity and for navigation. So the perennial rivers here in these plains are used for cultivation, generating electricity, and for navigation. For example, if we take river Ganga, which have water throughout the year, so it is called perennial river, which the water of Ganga is used for cultivation by the farmers, then the water of Ganga is also used to generate electricity and also for navigation. So we have finished this chapter. You read this whole chapter thoroughly to know this chapter very well. Thank you.